Hi, I'm Brittany Droz, and I help entrepreneurs make more money, become strong leaders, and develop awesome business culture that you would really be proud of. But I want to talk with you about one thing that makes all of this possible, and that is discernment. You might be puzzled by even my use of that word. If you were watching my videos a few weeks ago, you would have seen that I asked about who runs your business. Is it you or someone else? Are you putting off all the hard decisions to someone else for someone else to make? Well, that might be some use of discernment, which is ultimately making good judgments. And what you might have realized is that maybe you need some other people to help you make those judgments, those decisions. But really, this is where the art and the science of leadership collide. There is a lot, there's really a growing body of research around management, leadership, and how to be an awesome business owner. But at the heart of it, there are these decisions, there are these moments that no textbook, no whatever latest and greatest business book can tell you how to make that decision, how to move forward in that moment. And that is when that art kind of comes out. And this is when I want to talk about your use of discernment. So this comes out in so many of our teams and our groups, because we, as leaders, we need to discern, we need to determine, when am I making decisions as the leader and moving this organization forward? And when do I need to get input and empower other people to help? So this is one of those areas where I want you to think about how you are discerning when you need one or the other. When am I asking for input from my team to gather more information or to make a democratic decision? And when am I making the decision as a leader? So these have two different outcomes, right? Like, one, the team feels heard, they feel part of, you know, making policy in the organization, or if it's an external thing, they might feel more bought into making whatever change they need to in the organization or supporting it if in front of a customer, versus you knowing what needs to happen for your business and you making that decision and moving forward with it and kind of owning it. And there's going to be different repercussions for each of those decisions, but one is not right or wrong. They're just different situations where you need to use these different forms of decision making, and that is where you need to use discernment. Another area that I see business owners face challenges is with using their gut or their head to make a decision. And I'm sure you have all been there. Like, logically, you look at something and you're like, well, this is really the right move, or like, the numbers on the spreadsheet show me this is what I need to do, but my gut is telling me something different. And how do you reconcile those two things? I mean, one is not necessarily right or wrong, but how can we use both pieces of information to help you move forward? Now, there are times when you can't explain it, but you just know you need to move with this gut decision. And that is intuition. It might be years of experience telling you, but it maybe differs from what the numbers on the paper tell you to do. And there are other times where, and this can be particularly true in teams and when we're talking about our people in our organization or our customers, that, you know, it might be better to make the logical, rational decision because we can be too emotionally tied to the problem. So incorporating some more objective pieces of information can really help us discern what's happening here and what to do about it. And lastly, another area where I see us needing to really pull on that discernment muscle is in skill development or outsourcing tasks. And now this is really tough as a leader because, you know, we're taught like, oh, you know, we need to delegate in order to keep at the highest level of the organization. But often if we identify a skill gap in either ourselves or others, do we develop into that skill gap, to develop that weakness, like bring them on up? Or is that something we should outsource to an expert, to a consultant? You know, I mean, people bring me in because I can be a people expert. I can help them, you know, determine what's happening with behavior and what to do about it. So in that situation, it's more efficient to bring me in to help solve those problems than for you to develop that skill gap. But that's just one small example. There are plenty of reasons to maybe develop the skill gap on Canva if you're a small business owner and you can't afford to hire a marketing person full time. Or it's just, it's easier for your flow, for your social media to be able to create something on hand quickly in-house versus waiting in outsourcing. So timeliness, efficiency, you know, in an area where expertise isn't necessarily something you need in that moment. These are just a few examples of where we need to flex that discernment muscle. Asking for input versus making the decisions we need to make for the business. Using our gut versus using our head to make decisions in our business. And choosing to either develop a skill set or outsource it. Now, making good decisions, using good judgment, can actually get better over time. So if you feel like you are not excelling at this right now, that's okay. Don't worry about it. All I can ask you to do is try to get 1% better every day. And that compounded over time will make you an exponentially better decision maker and discerner for your business. So what I ask for in return, share a moment that you had to use discernment. And I don't care which direction it worked out for you, either it was awesome or it wasn't. I want to hear about what that example was and what you learned in the process. Thanks so much for watching today, and see you soon.